Greetings. One of the most fascinating jihads that Islam wages is to cast doubt on the Word of God, the Bible. Fascinating because it undermines Islam's own interests. Islam must simultaneously lean on and curse the Torah and Bible. Islam must lean on the Torah and Bible because the only credentials Muhammad could claim were from these very works. Muhammad tried to create imaginary credentials by claiming he was mentioned in the Torah and Bible. Surah 7:157, who follow the messenger, the unlettered prophet they find described in the Torah that is with them and in the gospel. 61:6, this is supposed to be, or allegedly, Jesus talking, giving you the good news of a messenger after me, meaning after Jesus, whose name is Ahmad. So Muhammad invented credentials for himself by claiming he was mentioned, foretold in the Torah and Bible. And I have many, many videos refuting the various verses and passages Islam twists to appear to fit Muhammad, to support Muhammad's claims. But after leaning on the Torah and Bible to give Muhammad credentials, Islam faces a dilemma. The Torah and Bible Muhammad invents credentials from refutes Muhammad and proves his message false. So Islam's only possible choice is to reject those parts of God's word that proved Muhammad a false prophet. They do this by claiming the Torah and Bible have been corrupted and changed from the quote-unquote original words Allah sent down to the prophets. And many videos have been spent stating the text of the Torah and Bible to prove those texts are true. But I think it falls on deaf ears because Muslims dismiss any text from the Bible as corrupted. And this is as logical and consistent as a Christian dismissing any quote from the Quran as an outright fabrication and lie. And while I think these two scenarios may appear to be irreconcilable duplications, I believe honest analysis, meta-thinking, can shed some light on which is the legitimate position to hold on to. For now, I will leave defense of Islam's mythological and logically incoherent position to itself. Wink, see how I dismissively toss aside as illogical and incoherent anything Islam has to say for itself. As a Christian, you should know that you know Jesus is the Son of God more than you value life. So what then is this analysis which I offer as so overwhelmingly certain? Buckle up. This is going off the path into the desert of cogitation. Islam claims the Torah and Bible are changed and corrupted. But no one ever bothers to ask and demand answers to who would make the change and why. Who seems obvious? The Jews. It's their book. And Islam would embellish this with the evil Jews. But not every person of Jewish lineage has opportunity to change every Torah on earth. That would therefore limit the set of possible offenders to those in charge. And I do not even think rabbis can logically be included in the set of suspects. Perhaps a few rabbis might be accused if they had some personal agenda which could benefit from a particular interpretation. But then, what benefit could any rabbi possibly glean from changing Prophet Isaiah's words? What benefit is to be gained by any man to change Prophet Malachi's message? And I struggle to find any benefit any rabbi might obtain from changing the vast majority of Old Testament scripture. there might be some benefit to contemporaneously change a message. For example, there is a clear violation of self-interest for a prophet to deliver a revelation that gives himself direct benefit during his lifetime. For example, when Prophet Isaliah told King David that prophets of God may have more wives than the king. Clearly, Prophet Isaliah simply wanted more sex than the king was allowed to have. Sorry, my bad. There was no biblical man named Prophet Isaliah who gave himself special rights. But that sounds familiar to me for some reason. Some man, a liar, who gave himself special rights, claiming to speak for Allah. Huh. I'm sure it'll come to me. Hopefully the concept is clear. A prophet telling lies would do so for his benefit. And that benefit would need to occur in his lifetime, or perhaps his children's. And yet Islam claims rabbis and scribes changed the Torah and Bible to what it is today. And what exactly is it today? Well, some would claim the Bible is a book antithetical to Jewish monotheism. The prophecies that teach Messiah would suffer and die cannot be resolved easily with the Messiah, the conquering king. Messiah, the seed of David, the lion of the tribe of Judah. And Islam's assertion requires you to believe rabbis and scribes created this incoherent, self-defeating story. Think about it. What possible motive would any Jewish leader have to create a story that appears to radically alter and subvert the very religion they hold dear? What benefit would any rabbi or scribe get for creating a web of facts that creates Christianity? There is a good chance this may be confusing to you. I completely understand. When one begins to gather and examine all the prophecies of Messiah, an objective examiner must quickly come to one set of conclusions. The Messiah is also the Son of God, and is even God in the flesh. What Jewish rabbi would contrive to invent that God has a son? What motive would any monotheist have to create a Son of God? The simple absurdity of the accusation is stupefying. Prophet after prophet revealed God is their Redeemer. That means God would redeem mankind somehow. What Jewish rabbi would contrive to invent such an obligation for God? Such an action would be an out-and-out damning lie, creating a false hope in the hearts and minds of faithful, righteous Jews. What possible reason, what motive would any man have to create such a lie? There is no plausible reason anyone from Islam can invent that does not also damn Muhammad. Muhammad changed the message for his benefit and gain in his lifetime. One could argue he did not change the message, but rather brought a whole new, different message. Because virtually nothing in Muhammad's Quran aligns with the Torah or Bible. So the next time you hear Islam's claim the Torah and Bible were corrupted, ask yourself, and the Muslim making the claim, why would Jews make changes that created the foundation of Christianity? That makes the Jews sound as stupid as Allah, who faked the crucifixion and lied to humanity for 600 years, thus creating Christianity. And only the most insane imagination would assert collusion between the Jews and Allah to form Christianity. though I believe it is not impossible, Democrats might assert the Russians helped Allah and the Jews. But I digress. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.